This, and any other BNT videos are not made, and or produced specifically for children under the age of 13.
My calculations are correct. When this baby hits 88 miles per hour, you're gonna see some serious shit.
Hello, back again with the DeLorean. What we see here is the bottom plate from issue 29. It's normally black. I did some primer on it yesterday evening and I intend to spray paint it a flat black. First, that was my first impression, spray painted flat black, but then I thought, no, maybe very dark gray with some black weathering. But then I thought, what if I make a mix of flat black, that's XF1, with, where's the jar, with X10, which is gun metal. So what I hope to create is a very, very dark, almost metal-y look, like underside of the car. I'm going to do that for the rest of the underside of the car as well, because I don't believe in a shiny black underside of a car, or at least not a car that's on the road. So let's try this. Let's try if it will work. Let's see if my airbrushes will work with me. Oh, I can see already that it's going to take several thin layers. Because I've not done the mixture wrong. But no biggie. Several thin layers of flat black and gunmetal. It's not 100% what I had intended, but this is eventually what I came up with. I said it wasn't going to be for shiny, but well, compared to the metal original version, my version is a bit more matted. Maybe I'm going to put some flat coat over it later, but for now, there's a slight hint of aluminum in there. There's a weird spot over here. I don't know what it is, but I'm probably going to add some, a little bit of grime underneath the, on the surface anyway, after everything has been put into place. And before I can do that, I will of course need to install, I'm sorry about all the noise in the background because my window's open and yeah, there's a lot of noise going on in the distance. Hold on, let me quickly check. I've turned the entire thing upside down, which was not necessary. I can actually turn it back this way. Okay, and let me quickly check the instructions where this particular item is going to come. It's going to come on the bottom. And it's going to be secured with DM screws. And you know what that means? Yes, we're going to use the oil for the DM screws. So let's put it on the bottom. And let's see how we're going to do this. Okay, so we need to hold it, I suppose, while screw it in. Okay, let me do that. Let me screw it in and I'll get back to you as soon as it's in. Okay, that one is in. Now we need to go to the BM screws, also metal. And we need to screw in this part, even though this part itself is plastic. Little notch over here. Sorry, a point over here, little notch over there. So just, we're gonna push it in. Now I have spray painted this part also because it was molded in black. And I have, if you know, may know, if you know, the painted the entire frame aluminum. At this moment, it's very stark, the contrast, because my aluminum frame has been wetted with oil paints. So this part will require that as well as soon as it is fixed in. And I have painted these screws aluminum. And that will be the next step I need to make. Okay, let's screw this one in. I don't really know why they made this a separate part. Oh well. Okay, so that actually is everything we need to do for issue 20. Which one is this? 26? Hold on. No, 29. This is a bit meager, but that's all we need to do. So, now I need to paint these screws aluminum and then use the same technique as I used over here to make sure that this part seems to be seems to be the same as the rest of this section. Let's do that. Something I never thought I'd find in the Netherlands. Well, maybe it was already here, but I could never find it. Aluminum tape. This is the tape you use for sealing pipes and so forth. I've never used this stuff before, but I've always seen it from fellow modelers. Why am I showing you this? There is a modification to good question. Step 30. Step 30 is the water lines or the water pipes underneath the car. As you can see, there's all these all pipes. Now, the modification I am referring to is the one I've seen on that website, which I've mentioned numerous of times, and that is use this tape. Hold on, use this tape, then cut. I would prefer, or I would suggest, actually, you cut it from the bottom. Cut small strips, and let me cut a small strip right now. Okay. Actually, it should be a bit thinner than that. And then use that strip and use the strip and stick it around the edges of these pipes. And that is to simulate the metal bracers of the original pipes. And as you can see, this one's over. You can never get this one straight. The one with the other with the website also didn't get this one straight. But these two are relatively straight, as you can see. The pipes are already pre-painted by Eaglemoss in a bit of a silver-like color. I'm gonna keep this color because if I have looked at photos of the underside of the DeLorean, these come very close. Now, there are some mold lines over here, but in this case, I'm gonna leave it as it is because the mold lines or the seam lines, I mean, are not visible from the car when it's already fixed in. So, apart from strips over here, there are also these bands coming over here. So, on the edge of every black section, these are supposedly rubber sections between those pipes. And we got one over here as well, and one over here. So, I'm going to use these strips and simulate the metal bands that is supposedly holding the rubber points of the metal pipes together. So, that is what I'm going to do, and then we're going to install all these pipes. All the pipes are in. Unfortunately, however, there's a problem with this one. I can't get this one in the correct hole. Now, if I try to focus it on here, as you might see, let's see, it's where this pipe, maybe I can point it out with a screwdriver. Hold on. Right here. I can't get into the hole, whatever I try. I can't actually see where the hole is. Now, I've used some super glue on this area as well as on this area, so it'll remain where it is. It's not going to fall out or something. And when you look at it, you can't actually see it because when you look from the top, from the car, when it's finally finished, you cannot see the connection. And I don't think from the underside you can see it as well. Maybe I can try once more. Maybe it's a bit lower. Hold on, let me try it again. Nope. Nope, I can't get it in. And I tried from the other side, so started trying to get this one in first and then maybe, but I can't get it in. So it'll have to be where it is. As I said, all the pipes are in. Let me zoom out the camera a little bit. All the pipes are in. So they start from over here in the so-called rubber pipes going into these silver line pipes. Let me turn the car around. Here, those pipes are emerging, as you can see, all the way over here to the front. and then go back up again. So let me turn the car over again, and they go into the radiator part of the car. So it's all fixed. Once again, let me turn it around on the bottom side. This, in fact, is indeed the correct color combination. Metallic black, aluminum, wetted aluminum, and these pipes are almost silver colored, and yes, these fixtures are actually almost chrome colored. So the combination of colors is correct. That concludes issue 30. Let me make some room over here. It's getting a bit heavy, this thing. Yeah, so thank you so much for joining me. Next week, what are we going to do next week? Let me quickly take a look. Next week we're going to have one very small and one reasonably longer issue. And the next issue will be these bottom plates, which need to be on... Oh, actually they're going on over here. On the bottom, as you can see, over there. I'm not quite sure what color they are in the kit. Maybe they're black. They're supposedly be silver colored, almost more glossy aluminum. So these will need to be resprayed as well. And then, of course, screwed in. That is all you have to do for issue 31. That's why we're also going to go with issue 32. Not quite sure what's in 32. And that may be a surprise, so stay with me and we'll see each other soon for the next episode of The DeLorean.
B&T! Custom-made models and dioramas. Ha! Like you click and subscribe you must.